What is the difference between the oxidation number and oxidation state? That we'll discuss now. So in the last class, whatever we discussed, the oxidation numbers, we all discussed about oxidation numbers, the charge present on the element, okay, in the molecule. Simply, you have taken as what here? Oxidation number, actually, right? Now, let me take now here oxidation state. So just now it will be writing a time. It takes few minutes. If I write. Right. I will take one example over here, beta. So I have taken H2SO3, beta. This example I have taken. Right, beta? H2SO3. Now tell me, what is the oxidation number of sulfur? What is the oxidation number of sulfur? Anybody? Tell me, beta, what is oxidation number of sulfur? Calculate that one. The previous are you there, beta? Is my voice audible?
Sir, 2.
Yes, sir.
Right, beta. How much beta you are getting?
Plus 2.
If anybody have problem, let me see. Two hydrogens are there. For hydrogen, plus 1. Two sulfurs we are calculating. Next, three oxygens are there. And each oxygen is minus 2, that equal to 0. Now, based on this, 2 sulfur is equal to what we get? Plus 4. And 1 sulfur is equal to what here? Plus 2. Now, the sulfur oxidation number is plus 2 bit. The sulfur oxidation number is plus 2. Understood. Now, what is the oxidation state of sulfur here? This is oxidation number we calculated. We got that is plus 2. Now, what is the oxidation state means individually what it is. Now, when you observe this formula here, it looks like S, okay, OH, and here also we get here OH, and here we get double bond S, and here we get double bond O. Now, this is a structure of what? H2SO4, beta. H2SO3, sorry. Structure of what? H2SO3, beta. Now, in this case, there are two sulfurs. Okay? This is the average value, beta. This is an average value. Correct or not? Oxidation number is an average value. Both are getting average is equal to plus. But individually, if you observe here, this sulfur and this sulfur, if you observe, they are getting different oxidation states. In the molecule, both sulfurs will have same oxidation number. They have different oxidation number. That's what we're calling as oxidation state. Okay? When you have, isn't it, two different elements are there, so two same elements are there, and they may get different oxidation states here. They may get different oxidation states. For this one, if you observe here, for this sulfur, if you observe here, this will be minus 2, and this will be how much here? If you observe what happened, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm writing here what happened, plus 4. Because number of bonds I'm taking here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now plus 4 minus 2 is equal to plus 2. You got individually plus 2. Okay. Now why this minus 2, I will explain later, okay, by taking different number of examples. So what I mean to say is that it is an individual charge present in the given molecule, this will be an average value, right? Now let me take next one, Stark notation. Stark notation is a very simple topic. It is Stark notation. Now what is the meaning of Stark notation? Very simple, beta. For example, I have taken one of the example. Which example? Let me take iron oxide. I'm taking it. Very good example, iron oxide. Now, what is the oxidation state of iron, beta, in this one? What is oxygen state of iron, beta? Yes. Plus one. Oxygen state of iron. ऑक्सीजन के कितना हो जाएगा चार्ज? इतनी बार हमने एक्सरसाइज किया, मेनी नंबर ऑफ एग्जांपल्स वी हैव डन, स्टिल यू आर सेइंग व्हाट हैपेंड? ऑक्सीजन का कितना, आयरन ऑक्साइड, ऑक्साइड है ना ये, कितना हो जाएगा बेटा? ऑक्सीजन का कितना है लेना है अभी? Yes, minus 2 is equal to 0. कितना होगा आयरन का? कितना होगा? Plus 2, very simple. Now this plus 2, if we write in Roman letters, isn't it? If we write in Roman letters, when you're writing the nomenclature, when you're writing the nomenclature, iron oxide, isn't it? Iron oxide. This iron oxide, you're writing like iron in bracket, 2 is there, no, put like this, as a 2, oxide. Now this type of representation is called Stark notation. Understood better? Stark notation, we can call this. Now you take one more example, manganese dioxide. Now tell me, what is the oxygen state of manganese beta in this case? The oxygen state of manganese beta? In this case, the oxygen state of manganese beta, tell me beta. Manganese oxide, oxygen state, manganese का बोल रहा हूँ मैं, कितना हो जाएगा?
Plus four,
right? Manganese oxidation state, plus four. So I'm writing manganese, okay? Iron, कितना है आंसर? Manganese कितना oxide? Four oxide. This is called Stark notation. So in this way, we can write many number of examples are there. Useful in examination. Therefore, always, all of you, what happened? Remember like this. Okay? You can write in terms of molecular formula also. You can write in terms of nomenclature also. You see, manganese 4 oxide. For example, MnO. MnO. Oxygen state kitna hai? Plus 2. So kitna le aapko? 2 lena. Okay? Copper. Cupric oxide. Kitna oxygen state? Plus 2. So, you can take like this also in the nomenclature way also you can take. Or you can take in the structure also like, you see. SnCl4 beta. SnCl4. Chlorine kitna hai negative charge? Minus 1 hai. 17 group. Just like chlorine, minus 1. So, tin kitna aayega beta? Kitna aayega aapko? 4. Like this. 4 chlorines are there, no? Therefore, we get 10 plus 4. So, this is called what? Stark notation, very simple concept. But if you know how to calculate the oxidation number, then only we can do the Stark notation. Because everyone, I think, knows the Roman letters from 1 to 10. But up, you will get up to 1, up 6 or 7. In final, lastly, we get 7. Or most of the case, very few cases we get 8. Okay, so 9 we don't get, impossible. Because we have only 8 A groups are there, so we don't get 9. Right? Remember that, beta, only up to 1 to 8 you may get oxidation numbers. More than 8 you don't get, it is impossible. Because how many groups you have? 1 A to 8 A groups. Therefore, you don't get more than 8 actually. Right? So this is about the Stark notation and oxidation number. So some examples are there in the oxidation number and examples are there. We'll discuss that one. So first of all, we'll complete this types of redox reactions bit. Okay. So today we complete this types of redox reaction. After that, we'll discuss few more examples to calculate the oxidation number, especially the peroxides, right? Let me see these types of reactions now. So I think you have read these types of reactions in the 10th class level. Everyone knows this one, I think. Everyone remember also that one. What are they? Let me see now. How many types are there? Let me see. The first thing, if you observe, combination reactions. First type is called combination reactions. Second type is called decomposition reactions. Then okay. Third one is displacement, double displacement. Both will be there. Okay, displacement, double displacement. Disproportionation reaction, and finally what happened? Comproportionation reactions. Total what happened? 5, isn't it? So let me discuss each and everything. The first one is combination reactions. Chemical combination reactions. Let me see the combination reactions here. Now, which type of reactions are called combination reactions, beta? Which type of reactions are called combination reactions? Right? Is visible, beta? Screen is visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is there in this one? Anybody read out this one? Anybody?
Sir.
Read the beta. Definition, read anybody.
Redox reaction in which two elements combine to form a single product is known as chemical combination reaction.
Very good, beta. Very good. Two elements, okay? Two elements are combining here to give what actually a single product, beta. Two are combining to give a single here. For example, you are making something, what happened? You are making some type of food you are making, right? You are adding all ingredients to that one. You will get a finally a single product. That means you make a final product from that. By adding everything, you are making a curry from that. Okay, you are making a dish from that. So by adding everything, okay, simply you can remember like that. If when in examination, if they ask what happened, you are making a dish. How you make a dish? Adding everything, ingredients, you are getting a single dish only. Okay, like this. A, I'm writing here something. A, two elements. A plus B are combining to give what actually C, single product. This is called what? Chemical combination reactions. Now let me take example. Magnesium when react with chlorine, okay, or oxygen. You can take anything better. Magnesium react with oxygen, magnesium oxide. Magnesium react with chlorine, magnesium chloride, like that. Okay. Now magnesium react with oxygen to give magnesium oxide. See, this is the thing. A, okay, B, giving what here? C lattice. Two elements combining to form single product is nothing but chemical combination reaction. In this case, whether this is redox reaction or not, let me discuss about this. This reaction is redox or not. I told you there will be no oxidation reduction separately. Independently, oxidation does not exist. Independently, redox reaction, reduction reaction does not exist. But redox reaction takes place. Without oxidation, there is no reduction. Without reduction, there is no oxidation. Now, this is a redox reaction in which you observe magnesium, beta. You observe magnesium here. Now, what is the oxygen state, beta? Zero. Converting into plus two. Which reaction? Pradhamesh? Which reaction?
Yes,
which reaction? Zero converting into plus two?
So reduction.
Re beta, zero converting into plus two, positive charge increasing. Zero is plus, positive is
oxidation.
Oxidation reaction. Oxidation. Next, we will see the oxygen. Now, see, zero converting into minus two. Pradhamesh, bolo beta.
So reduction.
Reduction. Minus increasing. Remember, beta, minus zero. Again, I'm writing. Don't get any confusion, beta. If positive charge is increasing, positive charge increasing, that means what happened? Plus two. Two or something plus three, whatever it may be. Positive is increasing. Which reaction? Oxidation. Now, zero to positive, also called positive oxidation reaction. When zero converting into positive, oxidation. Next, when negative charge decreasing, when negative charge is decreasing, that means what happened? Minus 3 to, isn't it? Minus 2, like that. negative decreasing, also called oxidation. Now remember, remaining if you observe, negative charge increasing, minus 2 to minus 3. Which reaction beta? Reduction reaction. 0 to negative. Which reaction beta? Reduction reaction. Next, what happened? Positive charge. Positive charge decreasing, plus 2 to plus 1. What is this one? Reduction reaction. All these three concepts, only based on these three concepts only, we can say it is oxidation or reduction. Only three concepts you have to see. What are they? Negative charge decreasing, negative charge increasing. Positive charge increasing, positive charge decreasing. Zero to positive, zero to negative. So how many are there? Positive charge increasing, zero to positive, negative charge is decreasing. Here also, negative charge is increasing, zero to negative, then positive charge decreasing. In this way, we can easily remember that. So all of you make a notes for this one. I told you in the last previous class also, I told you make this one notes. Okay, so that you can easily remember. So we got a reduction reaction. So the reaction in which both oxidation and reduction taking place, that reactions are called what? Redox reactions. Very simple. Now in examination, what type of questions you may get here? First of all, in MCQs. In MCQs, which type of reaction, the following is which type of reaction. Otherwise, the reaction with magnesium and oxygen to give magnesium oxide is which type of reaction? Definitely what happened? Combination, chemical combination, redox reaction. Chemical combination reaction. Right? This is the first thing better. In this, magnesium undergo oxidation and oxygen undergo reduction. Now tell me beta, which is oxidizing agent?
Oxidation.
Yes, beta?
Oxygen.
Oxygen. Reduction. Oxygen undergoing reduction. Therefore, it is called oxidizing agent. Now, magnesium undergoing oxidation. Therefore, it is called what?
Reducing agent.
Reduction.
Reducing agent. What reduction? Understood? Magnesium undergo oxidation called as reducing agent. Oxygen undergo reduction, oxygen is called oxidizing agent. The substance which undergo reduction called as oxidizing agent. The substance which undergo oxidation, reducing agent. So, itni simple se main bataya, phir bhi aap exam mein galti karte. Oxidation reaction ko oxidizing agent karte aap log. Thoda practice karna hai. Right? Next, we'll see the decomposition reaction. Opposite to what? Combination is called what? Decomposition. Now in this case, two or more components, isn't it? In which at least one of them is elemental form. Generally they are given like this, but definition we can also modify like this. A redox reaction is molecule breaks into two or more components. See, means what happened? A is converting into B plus. Better to have. If you read like this, what happened? You may get something what happened, doubtful it is. Okay, you may not understand this one. Molecule is breaking into two or more components means A is converting into B plus C or more than B plus C also. Not only you can take B plus C, more than B plus C. In combination also you can take more than two or three. But generally what happened, only two will combine, and most of the case one will decompose into two. Or very few cases it will decompose into three actually. Most of the cases a molecule will decompose into two only. So we'll take one example better. Sodium hydride. Okay, converting into sodium hydrogen like this. Best example, you can take this one also better. Sodium. You observe better? Hydrogen minus 1. Converting into 0. Anybody tell me which reaction better it is? Negative charge decreasing.
Oxidation.
Oxidation reaction. Yes, it is an oxidation reaction. Once it is oxidation, remaining will be reduction. Now it is what? Which type of reaction beta this one? Reduction reaction. So definitely for an example for decomposition. You can take number of examples you can take. Mercuric oxide. Again, here also you can take one more example. Hydrogen and oxygen forming from water. You can take this one. Plus 2 beta. Yapar kitna beta? 0. Minus 2. Yahan par kitna? Elemental hai na? 0. See, they are elemental form beta. Sodium elemental form, hydrogen element form. Therefore, you have to take kitna dekhne? Zero dekhne. Hydrogen elemental form, zero. Oxygen elemental form, zero. Water, oxygen will be minus two. One hydrogen will be plus one and two hydrogen will be plus two. Definitely, you can take any example in examination, right? So you may get in theory also. They may ask, right? The definition of decomposition, other state decomposition with a beautiful example. They ask. So you have to state the statement, write the statement, and give one example. After, when you give example, also you have to show which is undergoing oxidation. Like this, you have to show this one. In this way, you have to show. No need. See, don't write simply the reaction. Now, which substance undergo oxidation? And this substance undergo reduction, you have to show like that. Right. Next, you will see the any doubts you are having data, decomposition and combination reaction. Mein kuch doubt hai to aap pooch sakte hain.
No, sir.
No. Right. Let me see the displacement beta. Displacement reaction. Now, what is this displacement? Let me see by example. Now here. Which is reap is called what displacement. Now, for example, Y is there. Y displaced. The position of the Y is displaced by an atom called X. In the position of Y, what we got here? X. So we'll take an example here. The metal displacement. Copper sulfate, zinc reacting beta. You got zinc sulfate. So beta, all of you remember beta, SO4 overall charge will be minus 2. Overall charge will be minus 2 beta. Remember always, if sulfate ion is having minus 2, copper will have how much beta? Copper oxygen state will be how much beta? Phenol is there? Phenol. Absent. Omkar M, Omkar C, absent. Raghav.
Plus two, sir.
कौन बोल रहा है बेटा?
Raghav.
हाँ. Plus two. Very good, बेटा. Remaining is Omkar C, Omkar M, Krunal and absent today. So I put absent mark for them. Yes, beta, SO4 minus 2, always it will be minus 2. Copper will be definitely plus 2 here. Here, but is visible. The screen may be dikh rahe hain. Phir bhi aap nahi bol rahe to, you are not listening to the class. Screen pe yahan par dikh rahe hain aapko, plus 2. It's visible on screen. Still, you are not making the answer means you are not watching the video. Right. Now, what is happening, beta, yahan par? You see, the position of the copper is taken by whom beta? Zinc. So metal displacement, the metal is displacing another metal. Metal displaced another metal. In this case, metal displaced metal only. Because copper is metal, zinc is metal here. Zinc is elemental form, zero oxidation state. Copper plus two. Now you see, the plus two, what is happening? Whether it is a redox reaction or not, let me discuss this. Now plus two, convert into copper beta. Raj, which reaction beta? Plus 2 converting into 0?
Reduction, sir.
Very good beta. Reduction reaction. Like zinc converting into zinc plus 2?
Oxidation.
Oxidation. So definitely it is a redox reaction in which metal is displacing with metal. Very good beta. Now this is called what? Displacement of metal. Next, we'll discuss about you. All of you practice this example better. Practice this example. Because in examination, what happened? You will get exam. They will ask examples only. Definition, okay, but examples are very important for MCQ questions. You can take n number of examples. You see, in this example, aluminum is metal, chromium also metal better. Now the position of the chromium is took by whom beta? Aluminium. Now in the place of chromium we got aluminum. Now you observe plus 3 converting into 0 reduction, 0 converting into plus 3 oxidation. So best examples. So these two examples you practice for this one. And this is the textbook also better. It will be non-metal displacement reaction. Non-metal displacement reactions. Now what are these non-metals like hydrogen? What are the non-metals you are taking? Hydrogen are displaced by the first A group elements and second A group elements. Let me discuss this one better. Now you observe it. This is a metal beta. Calcium is a, generally what happens is a metal only. Because it loses electron. This will be hydrogen will be what here? Non-metal. That means here non-metals like hydrogen are displaced by the metals. Displaced by the metals. Previous case metal is displacing metal. Now non-metals are displaced by the metals. Now the position of this hydrogen here, one of the hydrogen, not all the hydrogen, one of the hydrogen, because water contains what beta? Listen beta, but carefully you have to watch this video now. H plus and OH minus is equal to water, correct or not beta? H plus and OH minus is equal to water. Now calcium can exhibit what oxidation state beta? Which group element calcium? Anybody?
Plus 2.
Plus 2, very good. Second group element, plus 2. Now, see, whenever a metal is displacing, okay, for example, if it is having positive charge, generally metals will have positive charge, it will displace only positive beta, not negative. Remember this concept is very simple. Metal can displace only cation, but not anions here. Because metals can exhibit positive character, they can displace only cations. Now, what is cation in the water beta? In water, which is cation beta? Which one is a cation? In water?
Cation. Plus.
Which one beta? Cation.
Plus.
H plus beta. H plus is cation. So metal like calcium cannot displace OH minus because OH minus is negative. Now which place? Displace what beta? H plus. So from water, H plus can be displaced by what? Calcium. So now I have taken two water molecules beta. I have taken how many? Two water molecules. Now, how many H plus ions I will get here? 2 H plus ions and 2 OH minus ions. Now, calcium, isn't it, will take the position of the hydrogen H plus ions here. Because 1 plus 2 is equal to 2 H plus ions. Now, 2 H plus ions is equal to how much beta? 1 calcium ion. Correct or not beta? 2 H plus ions is equal to 1 calcium plus 2. Why? Because you have to consider the charges here. 2 into plus is equal to overall plus 2 here. Here also what plus 2. So now what happened here? We get calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas will be liberated. Understood everyone? Any doubts you are having regarding this reaction? You can speak now. If you have any doubts, you can speak now. No doubts?
No, sir.
Yes. We'll take number of examples like this beta. Iron, isn't it? Replacing what actually? H plus ion, you see? In this case. Now here you may get doubt, sir, where is the OH minus here? In this case, where is the OH minus here? Iron little bit more active than the calcium. Generally what happens in this case, you will get like this. Water will dissociate into 2H plus and O minus 2. Now, here the reaction will replaces what? H plus, all the H plus ions. Understood beta? It's a very simple example. H plus ions are replaced with what here? Zinc here. These reactions are used to prepare hydrogen gas. See, they are used to prepare what? Now in all the cases, the second and third cases, which ions are replaced here? H plus ions here. Isn't it? All these cases, first two, three cases, what happened? Which ions are replaced here? H plus, H plus, H plus. And that H plus ions are converting into what here? Hydrogen gas. Next, we'll take what? Reactivity of halogens here. This will not be in the syllabus, I think, that we'll discuss. We go for disproportionation reaction. No? You see, beta, jitna example diya, all these examples you have right. All of you, aaj ka kaam kya hai aapka? Definition likhna hai. Jo textbook mein examples diya hai na, wo sari examples aapka notebook mein likhna hai compulsory. Reactions bhi hum kya karenge, koi baat nahi. Pehle ek kaam karenge. नॉन डिस्प्लेसमेंट होने के बाद एक काम करेंगे, डिस्प्लेसमेंट करेंगे. और कितना टाइम है अभी? 9:45. ओके. दिस विल कंप्लीट. जस्ट दिस थिंग, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, डिस्प्रोपोर्शन, कम प्रोपोर्शन विल डिस्कस टुमारो. लेट वी डिस्कस सम रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ हैलोजन्स इन विच. नाउ इफ यू ऑब्जर्व इन दिस रिएक्शन बेटा, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन दिस केस? What happening in this case, beta?
Sir, fluorine is displacing chlorine.
Fluorine displacing what actually? Chlorine, beta. See, fluorine displacing the chlorine. Okay, the position of the fluorine took by whom, beta? Now this is for non-metal displacing the non-metal. Non-metal displace non-metal. Right now here, fluorine is non-metal displacing what happened here? Chlorine here. See, now in the position of the chlorine, which we got here? Fluorine. Now based on this reaction, you can say fluorine is more reactive. Fluorine is what? More reactive than what? Chlorine here. Next we go to one more example. Fluorine react with KBr. So now in this case, what happened? See, again fluorine displacing the bromine. All are redox reactions only. Okay, no need to again write the oxidation state here. All are what? Redox reactions, right? So here fluorine is more reactive than the bromine. So similarly chlorine, if I write what happened, chlorine I am writing. So in this case you write like this. Better to understand, you write like this. Two moles of KBr, you write. KBr. You write two moles of, because you may get confused here. KCl. Okay. Now what happening here, beta? Chlorine replacing the bromine here. Now based on this sentence, what we can say? Anybody? Based upon this reaction, what we can say, beta? Reactivity. In terms of reactivity, what we can say? Anybody?
Chlorine is more reactive than bromine.
Very good, beta. Chlorine is more reactive than the bromine. So this, what happened? Finally, isn't it? Finally, what happened? It's here also you can write 2i, 2ki, beta. Just to write what happened, 2ki. Here we're getting what? 2KCl. Now here also we can say what happened. Chlorine is more reactive than the iodine here. So based on this, okay, generally what happened, this liberation we can easily identify based upon the color, whether iodine is formed or not. See, whether iodine is formed, the bromine is formed, we can see, we get the color action. Based upon the color, we get that. So what I'm saying, therefore, the order of reactivity is this one. This is the order of reactivity. So the order of it. Even singly, what happened? Bromine can displaces the iodine also, like potassium iodide. If you take what happened, you are going to get KBr plus what happened? I2. So based upon this, bromine is more reactive than what? Iodine. So you see, bromine is more reactive than iodine. So this is the order of reactivity. All of you remember this. Understood, beta? Any doubts?
Yes,
any doubts you are having? Very simple, no? So this is the topics today, and the next topic, disproportionation, we'll discuss tomorrow class, right? Tomorrow class we'll discuss, and tomorrow we'll discuss some more oxidation states of parasites also we'll discuss. Right.